Hey, today I want to share with you an interesting game that features Sicilian defense and open Sicilians, and it is a quite crazy game, both sides attacking like hell. And the point of this game, the main point of this game is that what to do if your opponent launches a crazy attack against your king, and especially if you are black, you are down a tempo. You make the second move basically. And I'm black in this game, and I want to show you, let me tell you, I want to show you how to defend by attacking. You don't need to defend if your king is under attack. Sometimes its best defense is to attack. So this is Sicilian, open Sicilian, knight f3 is open Sicilian, otherwise it was going to play like g3 or something like that. I go to hyper accelerated dragon. First I develop bishop and then I develop knights. Takes and he plays a strange move, like looks like speed mora or Danish gambit, but it is not exactly, but okay, we go for it. And I continue my hyper accelerated dragon style just to develop the bishop before the knight, preventing the queen or knight going to the d4 square. And now I'm developing the knight, and my opponent develops the bishop very quickly. Seems he wants to castle queen side because of developing this bishop. Also, there is another reason that he wants to just launch a crazy attack and pour as much as possible pieces he has towards my king side. I develop my knight to f6. I was thinking whether to go to f6 or h6 at this moment, because f6, obviously my opponent plays pawn e5 and pushes my knight away. This is one obvious move, and I'm behind one move. It's by tempo, but then I thought that okay, yes, it's bad, but I can also attack that pawn and force him to defend that pawn, prevent him to continue his attacking aggressive like style that he has, sacking a pawn and then developing every pieces before castling is very aggressive. Also, I saw that if I go to h6 with knight, then he played bishop g5 to later play queen d2 and then put the bishop to h6 and then exchange his bishop with my bishop. If I go knight to h6 after queen d2, I should retreat the knight. So it doesn't change the situation. Like if he pushed the pawn, I should go back. If he put the knight in h6 and then he put the queen to d2, I should go back again. So why not attacking the pawn? So I this is the reason that I played knight f6, and he, as anticipated, played queen d2. I castled anyways. I said that okay, you're going to play bishop h6 and exchange your bishop with my bishop and launch an attack. But I'm castling and I'm also attacking you. So far it's not clear how I'm attacking. First I expel this bishop. This bishop is very strong there, because at some point he pushes the h pawn and pushes the h pawn forward, and finally it exchanges his h pawn with my g pawn. And I would like to take it back with the f pawn, not with the h pawn. And I cannot at the moment, because his bishop is attacking my f1. So I should attack his bishop and expel it. He cannot sit and watch. He should do something. He moved the bishop away. The bishop didn't have any good square to go right. If it was retreating backward, I was exchanging with knight. Forward had only one square. D5, but this was very bad, I believe. I had many moves against it, like pushing e6, attacking bishop, or taking the bishop with the knight. Anything was possible. So he retreated the bishop, and I said that okay, it's time to bring my bishop in. He started again, anticipated move that you expected. Let hurry the h pawn, push it. Push. I develop my bishop. Maybe at some point I play knight to c4. and I want the defender to be there, and bishop is there, as it's not just playing knight there, also it's not just developing bishop. There are two other reasons that I put the bishop on e6. First, moving the bishop away and developing it, enabling my rook or my queen to reach out c8. But the most important one is that, again, in such a structures, my knight on f6 is a very important piece, and white doesn't like that. Why knight at f6 is important? Because imagine the moment that everything is exchanged, and his bishop is exchanged with mine, and his queen is on h6, and the file is open. The rook and queen are lined up in the h file, and he can take the h pawn, and the only thing prevents this is my knight on f6. So he wants to expel my knight, and one idea that he usually have is to play knight d5 and then knight exchange the knight with my knight. So I said that if you play knight d5, I will take it with bishop, and I'm very happy with that. I don't let you to come in. So it's not completely crazy attacking by my Forno. Okay, he goes for, prepare a defensive setup, and then I go for attack. He pushes the pawn, and no, at this moment, I don't care. You shouldn't be worried, wow, what should I do? I could have taken the pawn with the knight, but I said, okay, take it, I don't care. I want to develop my queen and attack to your b-pawn. Why? Because I expect that he moved the queen to h6 at some point, and the b-pawn is defenseless, and I can take it. It's not that it's I win a pawn. Is that I'm destroying his structure, or forcing him to castle queenside. If he castle queenside, then my rook's joining the attack, and now the open C file shows it's important. So it's not just simply attacking some point and pinning his queen to defend that pawn. No, it's not that. And as you remember, I said that at some point I'd like to take that pawn with the f1, and this is that moment. He takes, he says check, all expected, and I go back. He comes in with the knight. What to do? Ooh, it's scary, right? What to do? Defend the h-pawn with playing rook f7 or something like that? No. The whole point of playing queen b6 was saying that, okay, you have some weaknesses, you cannot simply attack me, because I also attack you. It's not like you have all the fun. I also have a lot of fun. And he is not care about what is going on with his king. First, I take that this is important, or maybe not that important, but it's important in itself, I believe, at least in the blitz game that we play. First, take the knight, because either he retreat the queen and I exchange the queen and I win, or he doesn't retreat the queen, then I take the rook with check, and he's down a lot of material. Then I can sack everything I want to defend, right? So I'm not care about his attack then. No, I'm up two pieces, right? I'm up two pieces, and with these two checks. And I played this move. I didn't want to exchange my knight with his knight. Also, I want to give a check too. Okay, at that moment, at this moment, I have a mating attack basically. But I didn't see mating attack. I saw something else. And for this, I took that pawn. Takes. I give this check. And here, I saw that if he takes my knight, I will mate it. So he cannot take it. Calculate it on your own. He cannot take it basically, and he defends, and this was the reason that I gave that check, because I wanted to exchange my queen with his queen, and now he's under check. He should move the king away, and after moves the king, no, I take the queen, and no is game over basically. He was very angry at this moment, and I gave another check to exchange every remaining piece, because I'm up a complete rook and several pawns, okay, and and two pawns, and very strong pawn structure by me. And I gave up my rook for his knight. I said that exchange every piece you have, my friend, and he was very angry. I mean, at this position, look at the position. And he played very crazy move h5 and give up the game. So this was the story. Don't worry if your opponent attacks. Develop carefully, prepare for your own attack, and at the right moment launch your own attack, and don't be afraid of his bombs. Bye.